God is speaking to you. You. The Bible says that God's plans for man is amazing. Eye hath not seen, nor ear heard, the things that God has prepared for them that love Him. But though eye has not seen, nor ear heard, the Holy Spirit has revealed everything to us. And I want you to understand that you have been chosen by God to love Him. That's why all things work together, not separately, work together for good. To them that love God, to them that are the called according to His purpose. Now, my dear child of God, you are defined as a person who is called according to His purpose, not according to your purpose. It was His purpose and He called you. And the reason is that you should love Him. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, and with all thy might. And I want you to understand the reason why you should love Him. Because you had forsaken Him. You've gone away from Him. You're far off. You're doing things, rebellious things. You're living in sin. God loved you. And His plan and purpose started operating. And that's why God met you. You had a divine encounter. And He opened your eyes. And He made you a son of God. Today, you are a son of God. Never forget that. In fact, you should confess who you are. You are a son. That means you are not an orphan. You are not fatherless. You have a father. And your father is God. Not only did He make you a son, He's made you His heir. That's why the Bible calls you as heir of God. That's amazing, because in this world right now, you are an heir. And above all, God took away all the sin from you and He made you righteousness of God. Now that's amazing. Son of God, heir of God, righteousness of God. Now today you can go directly before the throne of grace, because God does not see your old man. He sees His righteousness. Righteousness of God doesn't have any imperfection. But at the same time, you who have been made heir of God, son of God, and righteousness of God, you should awake unto righteousness. You can't afford to live like those who have not been made heirs and sons and righteousness of God. They don't know anything. The Holy Spirit doesn't dwell inside them. The Apostle Paul also says that we who have received the first fruits of the Spirit, which means you have received the first fruits of the Spirit. So once you have an understanding about who you are, the Spirit inside you, the anointing inside you, will start working each and every day so that you may do the things that God has chosen you to do. And I want you to understand that when you understand the plan of God and when you surrender yourself, because God is not going to force you, He's only going to teach you. And when you receive the teaching and you allow the anointing to work inside you, the anointing will make you to obey. You can't do anything with your own strength. The Bible says, if you through the Spirit do put to death the deeds of the body, which means the deeds of the body, though you are a heir of God, a son of God, a righteousness of God, will still be operating. And God expects us to put it to death. And to put it to death, God has given you the Holy Spirit. And that is why the Spirit of God is dwelling inside you. He is not an ordinary spirit. He is the Spirit who raised Jesus Christ from the dead. That awesome power which was used to raise Jesus from the dead. The same Holy Spirit is dwelling inside you. And He's going to help you to put to death the deeds of the body. Now listen, when you're going to do exactly what God expects you to do, you, the righteousness of God, if you're going to put to death the deeds of the body, you shall live. But if you're going to live after the flesh, you shall die. You've got to be very careful. Not think, oh, I'm the righteousness of God, I'm son of God, nothing will happen to you. The Bible very clearly says, if you live after the flesh, you shall die. But if you through the Spirit do put to death the deeds of the body, you shall live. And that is why we have to be very careful, because flesh is alive. And flesh is waiting for an opportunity. And if you give an opportunity, you can go into bondage. And that's very bad, because the plan of God for you is you should reign with Him. And if you have to reign, then you have to be a conqueror in this world. Not just confessing, I'm more than a conqueror. Show it by your action. Then you can't tell, I can't be a conqueror. You can't tell, this sin is too powerful. This temptation is too powerful. This pressure is too powerful. Nothing is powerful, because inside you there is the amazing anointing. This is the anointing that can do anything. This anointing can break anything. It can break any power of sin. Any work of the devil, it can break. And that anointing, God has put it inside you. There is power inside you. God is at work inside you. His power is at work inside you. Now unto him that is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. That means God's power is at work inside you. And he expects this power to be used every day. Use this power. Let not this power lie without being used. That will be of no use to anybody. You got to use this power and ask the anointing to help you, because the anointing which is inside you will teach you of all things. That anointing is right, it's not wrong, and God is going to lead you beside the still waters. You're going to be a great blessing. You're going to see amazing miracles. You're going to see his power unfold in such a way. And let me tell you something. If you are going to please God, if you're going to obey God, if you're going to groan like the apostles, if you're going to behave like a person who has received the first fruits of the Spirit, your family shall be blessed. Because of you, your children will be blessed. Your children will inherit the blessings because of your action. So why don't you go ahead, because of your family, because of your future, because of the love of God, and surrender yourself to God today and ask him, say, Lord, I want you to make me a totally new person. I've already been made. Actions do not reflect that. I want my mind to be chained in line with the word of God. Holy Spirit, help me. And I tell you, the Holy Spirit is ever ready to help you. And you will see God's power and goodness in the land of the living. God bless you.